acquaintances, admirers. Welcome here to this beautiful place on a day we would much rather was not here. But his departure from among us is still such a major blow, because in so many ways he was a man who was larger than life itself.
On behalf of my family, I'd like to give a big heartfelt thank you to today's CC's carers, Howard, Tyra, Father, Sarah, Patricia, Care Nurses, Dr. Laura Gilding, and Mum and Dad's special, very special friends, they know who they are, who have been involved in caring for Dad and providing wonderful support for Mum. And it's been a very difficult journey with many ups and downs, and without these people offering me help, skills and time, Dad wouldn't have been able to stay at home as long as he did. Mum, I think you're an amazing woman, a great role model to us all. You have been Dad's rock, best friend, and best protector of his dignity, well-being and independence.
I was just here, as most teenagers are, when meeting the father of their girlfriend for the first time. He had worn an all-black jersey. Therefore, he must be sterile and awesome. Murray loved the all-blacks. In a radio interview, he was quoted as saying, after a particularly probing question was asked during what was quite a serious political talk, if you could change something, what would it be? And Murray's reply was simple, that the all-blacks keep on winning.
Dad didn't really like crying very much. So I tried to pass it on to my own kids, who were quite young. But of course, on the day he died, on Sunday, I was just a mess. And the tears were freely flowing, freely flowing. Kids were looking up at me going, what's going on? I see, you know, Papa always used to say to me, he said, it's okay to cry if you lose someone you really love or somebody leaves you really miss. And so I said that to him, and kids just looked at me going, why are you changing the rules, Dad?
There are times when there seems to be a split in my heart, and love goes in and out like breathing. The edges of me seem to kill over and inside out. This sounds maybe silly, and mostly I can't bring myself to speak, but I am me, full of stone and venom. But I came across a bat my cat had killed. It was a miracle. I could not believe the others healed it. Fur like spider, dandelion, and the membrane of its wings was like a sheet of fawn in the air. I felt like crying fragrance, God touching like a butterfly, and was gone. So, about that.
So, I guess I was too young to really get to know what my name is, Murray, and what everyone else did, but you know, all this remembrance.
Hello, everyone. Thank you very much for being here. This is our next to call. I just wanted to speak very briefly about these other men who are kids here. We've had a devastating reset week, starting with Murray dying in Lindsay last Sunday morning. It was so tragic just to see him go and take his last break. But we have been heartened by all the love and emotions which have been flooding into our home. So thank you for that and all the food and the cakes and the biscuits. It's just been wonderful.
Kia ora. G'day. We're doing my part of the world. A very good afternoon to you all. For those of you that don't know me, save I've just been introduced, my name is Ashley and I'm Pam's nephew. I really stand here as a representative of Pam's English family, her sisters, Val and Mary, with their partners Norman and John. Pam's other nieces, Lucy and Anna, with their husbands, Chris and Russell, and their children, Theo, Elizabeth, Chloe and Georgia. We should also not forget Pam's other niece, Helen, who's sadly already in the big paddock. She'll be there surrounded by the dogs. She'll be planting trees with bumblebees. She's getting the paddock ready for Murray. And I know that she's, if I know Helen truly, she'll also be getting the party well underway as well.
Yeah, well, most people, when they're introduced to somebody, say hello, or how are you, or something like that. But when Pam introduced me to Murray, more than 40 years ago, as a local science teacher, Murray immediately said, "I suppose you believe in some absolute truth in the universe." Which took me aback a bit, so I'm either around just as much as he is, so we went at it. In a few days we were on the golf course every Friday night, where we stayed for about 35 years. Competitive, you don't have a half of it. Even played in cyclone bowler.
So Paul Callaghan, New Zealand of the Year, once said, "What makes a great place is where talent wants to live." And may we say thank you to the Ball family for choosing Gisborne as your place, because I know that Fielding was the place of origin. And we as a community say thank you. Thank you for the marvellousness of Murray. Thank you for his contribution to our community. And it was really touching when we had Wallet Dog in the Marina Park, where the kids could actually make little bouquets and lay there by a Wallet Dog.
You are free. Go in peace. Taking with you the great affection, admiration and gratitude of so many. May you be embraced by all who you have ever loved. Thy family and friends have gone before you. May you walk in the light and count the wonders beyond our imagination. Come to realizations that cannot occur to us, hampered as we are by a mere five physical senses. I want to say to you, keep creating, Murray. Keep drawing and nurturing and making everything around you thrive.
Oh,